must up our game as a republic, and we must try as much as possible and make sure that at least our golfers get the much needed support. Now, it might be a little bit sad, but still something that we can pride of. A Ugandan is still in action, and he was able to make the cut. So long ago did we have not a Kenyan making the cut, but another person from the region. But all in all, he is the person that we're following, and we will be able to see how well and how far he will be able to go. Earlier, I was talking about the importance of corporates and the role they play in making sure that at least they get to support these golfers, because a number of our professional golfers did not play any golf, competition golf, for almost 7 months. They played some of them for the last 3, 4, 5 months, and we want them to win. Can we do better in supporting them? Maybe the gentleman next to me might be able to shed some more light on how important and the role that different corporates play in just trying as much as possible to support. Begin with your name, and what can we do as a country to at least be able to compete and compete to win?
Yeah. My name is Charles Wakabi. I work at Absa Bank as the head of sustainability and communications. First of all, it's a fantastic day. As you say, it's sad that, you know, no Kenyans are on the course today to follow. You know, but a shed of light, we have a Ugandan next door neighbor. You know, sports is one of the things that bring us all together. You know, and so it's no wonder you can see a lot of Kenyans following Ugandans, following a Ugandan golfer. I think we have to really think about this as a country. Yeah, we've hosted this tournament for this, I think, is the 55th of this tournament. You know, since this tournament gained the status that it has as part of DP World Tour, even earlier as a challenge tour, and even after I joined the main European tour, it's a challenge, Moses, because we haven't seen a Kenyan even make it top 10, right? You know, the last time that happened was Jacob Okello many years ago. And we have to really ask ourselves as a country, how do we better prepare to show up in these tournaments? Because, yes, it's doing a great job of putting our country out there. You know, so the sports tourism part of it is great. You know, the entrepreneurial aspects of the golf, you know, of the event is great here. If you look at all the setups, you know, all the entrepreneurs that are selling stuff here, you know, all the people that have gotten a livelihood out of this weekend. So it's great. It's got a positive, but we have to think about the cost spot as a country and say, what role can we play both as private sector as well as the government, you know, to begin nurturing young people so that at some point we can hope to hand a big prize, you know, the big prize money to a Kenyan.
I talk about a big prize. I know there is a lot that is happening, not just golf, because as much as we have in golf, tourism is also another important aspect, you will agree, that this kind of sport bring to this republic. And having this and having something again like Kipkeino Classic that brings global stars in the country is something that we need to have with more frequency.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, this tournament, Magical Kenya Open, presented by Absa, is viewed by about 400 million homes across the world. Yeah. If you think about that, you know, then you can see that there is true value for the country, Kenya. So, you know, one of our big foreign exchange earners is tourism, because you've got the best parks, you've got the best kind of facilities, tourism facilities in this region. And so this tournament allows us to put Kenya on that global pedestal, 400 million homes. So you can, if you think about the number of eyes that come across this country within, you know, as they follow this tournament, it's great value for country. But then, as you said rightly, it's over and above that, yeah, because there's what we are doing today. You know, in a couple of months we'll be doing the Absa Kipkeino Classic, you know, yet another great sporting event that puts Kenya on the global map. And truly that is why, as a brand, as Absa, we stand behind these things, not just because of the sports value of it, which is something that we identify with, celebrate and support, but also because of the greater value that this kind of tournaments and investments bring to our country.
Let's finish this conversation, and I'll take you. Sometimes we forget the ladies. And ladies, in a number of times, we've seen how well they will be able to play. I'll take you back to MKO, where at least this time out, the ladies got a reason to smile. Can we be able to balance this even better? And just maybe tell corporates that also in the ladies' games, there is something positive that we can also pride as a country.
Absolutely. So 2 weeks ago, we were in Vipingo, the Magical Kenya Ladies Open. You know, so, and yet another great showcase of great golfing talent. You're right, it's easy, especially in this kind of very competitive sports that have been traditionally dominated by men. It's easy for that, you know, for that factor to be forgotten. But this is something we're intentional about as a brand, and that's why you saw us at the Magical Kenya Ladies Open. And if you come to Muthaiga, you will marvel at the kind of at the kind of showcase there is for ladies who are Kenyan, who are doing great things. If you look at things, you know, like the setup we have here, these are lady led businesses. Yeah, the catering, the events management, it's fantastic, and it's fantastic to bring together Kenyans of all kind, young, old, male, female, to come together behind a great sporting event like this one and do something as fantastic as we are doing in Muthaiga this weekend.
Final sentiments. So moving forward next year, we'll be expecting to have much more big and maybe better kind of partnership?
Look, as I said, ABSA is really committed to, we celebrate, we identify with the spirit of every kind of sport. We support many types of sports. You'll find us in football, you'll find us in golf, you'll find us in athletics, and many other places. So for us, this is a strategic investment because it works both for our customers, who we are able to host and interact with at such passion points as sports. It also works for our brand because it helps put our brand out there, which is a great business investment, but also, and more importantly, because of the value that this kind of investments is building for our country and for our country sportsmen and women.
Thank you very much, and continue doing the fantastic work. And that's why actually I'm talking and saying how important corporates and the role that they play. I know I've been able to see some other kind of